Abby, wait. Shh. Did you hear it? Did you hear it? That's my stomach growling. Breakfast! Hello and welcome to Forward 40 TV. I'm Judette and you're so in the right place if you want stories, tips and ideas designed to help you grow more successful and more beautiful as you age. Today is Wednesday and you know what that is. Hey, it's a party over here. Hey, it's a party over there. Well, not quite that party, but today on hump day, I've got the A to Q, and it's a very special question that comes from Nadia Mahan, who writes, "Dear Judette, I love your Nowgo series. It is so inspirational, and frankly, I'm in need of huge dashes of inspiration right now. Here's what's on my mind. I am leaving Florida after being here for about 7.5 years, and I'm returning to Trinidad to live and make my way. The problem is, when I look at all my friends' Facebook pages, I get depressed. Everyone seems to be happy. Everyone except me, that is. My friends are either married, in great jobs and careers, and doing so well. I'm none of those things. I feel adrift and listless, like I don't have any clear goals. I'm coming back as a divorcee. I'm in debt, and I fear that when I get together with my friends, I'll feel inadequate and embarrassed about where I am in life. How can I stop these feelings? What the hell do you think is wrong with me?" Nadia, that was such a great question. Let me start by saying you deserve to feel listless and out of sorts. Going through a divorce, or any breakup for that matter, can nullify your soul. And it's a difficult process, emotionally, spiritually, and from your email, it seems as if your divorce was a shitty financial mess as well. So now is not the time to be hard on yourself. In fact, don't be afraid to identify now whatever it is that makes you angry, sad, scared, or frustrated. Your feelings, all of them, are valid, and they need to be acknowledged before they can be released. There is an exercise I want to share with you that I find really helpful every time I am hurting. I start with the feeling, so I acknowledge that I feel hurt. And then I go deeper or I go further and I'll ask myself, I feel hurt about. Then I go deeper. Whatever the source of the pain, it is completely worth the time and energy to do the work defining it more specifically. Remember that specifics are easier to work with and even more manageable than vague feelings. Secondly, Nadia, I want you to take the time as you're packing up your things and thinking about your next steps in Trinidad to grieve your loss and nurture yourself in the process. Buy yourself some flowers, take a hot bath, eat some chocolates, whatever feels right to you. Be kind and gentle to your spirit. Nadia, here's the most important piece of advice I can give you, and I don't care if you don't listen to anything else I said throughout this entire video. I want you to remember this. Get off Facebook. Yup, you heard my shizzle. Stop watching all that Facebook stuff where every attractive photo, every accomplished bio, and every successful status update will make you feel that everyone else but you is leading a perfect life. But the truth is, Nadia, many of your friends probably are not. But by constantly looking at other people's profiles and inviting constant comparisons, you will remain anxious about your return home by trying to keep up with what you imagine is the happiness of the Joneses. Now, that doesn't mean you can't reach out to your friends. On the contrary, you probably need to be networking, so go ahead and call people you love and who love you in return. Be as open as you want to be at this point. Do you want a job when you get back to Trinidad? Do you need to be introduced to new people? Do you want to lay low for a while? Be as clear as possible with what you need. It's like what Maya Angelou said, and yes, it's today's tweetable moment. Ask for what you want and be prepared to get it. Nadia, I found that happiness doesn't always come easy and that it takes work, like real grunt work. But I want you to remember, no funk lasts forever. That yes, pain can be numbing, but pain can also be healed with time and self-love once you allow new challenges to activate the very best of you. Got it, Nadia? Welcome home. Now, go.